I'm Pastor Salem, and I want to welcome you to the Christian Worship Hour. And we're always happy when the weekends come around and we can gather together all over the world and worship the Lord together. And we're going to be thinking about the believer's citizenship. Now, you're a citizen of some country somewhere, but when we accept Jesus, we are also a citizen of the kingdom of God, and that's what we're going to look at today. Well, we're reading from Romans chapter 13, and this is a passage on government. And we all live under some government, some type of government somewhere. And wherever you live, there's government. And God deals with that. It talks about that in Romans chapter 13, and beginning with the first verse. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers. That's the government he's talking about. Let every soul be subject unto the higher powers, for there is no power but of God. The powers that be are ordained of God. Whosoever therefore resisteth the power resisteth the ordinance of God, and they that resist shall receive to themselves damnation. For rulers are not a terror to good works, but to the evil. Wilt thou then not be afraid of the power? Do that which is good, and thou shalt have praise of the same. For he is the minister of God to thee for good. But if thou do that which is evil, be afraid, for he beareth not the sword in vain. For he is the minister of God, a revenger to execute wrath upon him that doeth evil. Wherefore ye must needs be subject not only for wrath, but for conscience' sake. For this cause pay ye tribute also, for they are God's ministers attending continually unto this very thing. Render therefore to all their dues, tribute to whom tribute is due, custom to whom custom, fear to whom fear, and honor to whom honor. In our prayer today, we're going to pray for the persecuted church in Jordan. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the governments, and some of them are fierce, and some of them we don't understand. But we know, have you told us in your word, every power, every government is ordained of God, and they are there because you will let them be there for a purpose, for a cause, and we do not know what it is all about. But we know that you are in charge, and you are every government is subject to you. And so we pray that you'll help us to be good citizens of the country in which we live, and also good citizens of the country of the kingdom of God when we accept your dear Son as our Savior. And so may we draw lessons from this service today that will make us better and stronger Christians. And then, dear Lord, we're praying for our brothers and sisters in Jordan today. And we know that there's a great influx of people coming in, and there are many of them are godless people, and many are hard, and the Christians are being persecuted, and some of their churches are being torn down or burned, and some of the Christians are being put to death, especially the men. And the little children, Lord, are separated from their parents, and they're orphans, and oh, dear. And so we just pray that I know you'll give them strength and help them not to give up, but to just put their faith truly in you and help them to know that all of these things that you're going to bring good out of them. Maybe we won't see them right now, but you are in charge. And so we submit to you gladly. So bless those dear, they are brothers and sisters. They're part of our heritage. And so bless them and help them. And because of their witness and their strength, may we be stronger believers where we are. And if we were faced with death, help us to be faithful unto death. So now, Lord, bless us in this service. We pray that many will turn to you and be saved. Many will enter the kingdom of God. They're just now in Satan's kingdom. They're in darkness. And may the light shine through, and by the wonderful light of the world, Jesus, and may they come to the saving knowledge of our Savior. And we'll give you all the praise and glory in Jesus' name. Amen.